It's peaceful. It's not the dangerous zone that they've made it out to be.
On the outskirts of Rio Grande City is where Yvette Gaitan has lived for over 40 years.
You can see the different pace of life that there is.
But her home, she says, would be demolished if a border wall is built in Starr County.
They're still going to cross over. It's just going to be easier for them to find help. And it's still going to take the same amount of time to process them. They're still going to get through it, under it, over it.
And she's not the only one concerned with losing her home due to the border wall.
The heavy machinery itself would probably demolish my home. That is if they don't have to tear it down to build the 25-foot maintenance road.
This is the home that Naida Alvarez stands to lose if a border wall is built through her property here in Starr County. She's lived on this land for over 40 years and even painted no border wall on her roof to make sure anyone that's flying by knows where she stands.
Once the damage is done, there's no turning back.
Naida has received three letters from Customs and Border Protection. In one, the federal government asked Naida to survey her land. She said no. Now they're preparing to sue her to gain access to her 8 acres of land.
Might not compare to people that have thousands of acres in their ranches, but to us, it's everything.
There's a lot of people that feel that, you know, all of the landowners out here that will lose their homes, they should really just take one for the country. What do you say to that?
If I would see that there was a crisis, I would be the first one to give up my home and say, build the wall. Only because I am so close to the supposedly crisis. I don't see it. I'm not afraid of the crisis because it doesn't exist.
According to CBP records, since the start of the fiscal year, Border Patrol agents have apprehended over 78,000 people in the Rio Grande Valley alone. And agents say Rio Grande City is a hot spot for drugs.
Rio Grande City Station continues to lead the nation in marijuana seizures.
But Naida says they're not crossing through her area.
I've never had immigrants knocking at my house. I haven't had anything stolen from my house like some people claim they do. We do not have that issue here.
The issue she has is figuring out what's next once construction starts.
If it does get built, I have no idea what I am going to do.
But one thing these neighbors are sure of is how hard they will fight.
What would you do once all the heavy machinery comes and the wall is built?
If it came down to it and the heavy machinery does come through, I would probably stand right in front of them and try and stop them from coming through. They would probably have to take me away in handcuffs to let them through.
The pair is suing the Trump administration in hopes it'll block and stop the president from building the border wall.
When are you going to stop fighting?
Never.
Reporting on the Texas-Mexico border, I'm Sydney Hernandez.